In the earlier session, we discussed about the operations of real numbers. What we have discussed, if you add, subtract, multiply, divide two irrational numbers, the result need not be an irrational number that we have discussed. And after that, what we have discussed, if you add, subtract, multiply, divide one rational number and the other should be the irrational number, then the result is always an irrational number that we have discussed. Now, and after that, we discussed about the rationalization. What is meant by the rationalization? Rationalization is nothing but the process of changing the irrational denominator to the rational denominator. That process we call it as a rationalization. And we discussed few problems about the rationalization. Now, our next concept is the exponents. Laws of exponents. These you already studied in your 8th class, but just have a brief recap about that one. What are the laws we know? A power m into a power n is nothing but a power m plus n. That means if the bases are same and if you are multiplying, you need to add the powers. And what is the next law of exponent? A power m by a power n, which is nothing but a power m minus n. That means if the bases are same and if you are dividing, you need to subtract the powers. And you already discussed a power m whole power n is nothing but a power m into n. And after that, anything to the power of 0 is 1. Right? So, and a power minus 1 is nothing but 1 by a. These all we studied in your earlier class and we already told how we got this one. Now, we are going to use this laws of exponents in the next exercise. And the next concept is consider 2 square is equal to 4, 2 cube is equal to 8, 2 power 4 is equal to 16, 2 power 5 is equal to 32, 2 power 6 is equal to 64. You know all these values. That means if you are multiplying 2 times, you are getting 4. And if you are multiplying 2, 3 times, you are getting 8. And if you are multiplying 2, 5 times, you are getting 32. If you are multiplying 2, 6 times, you are getting 64. You know all these things. But we will write this one in the form of the roots. How do you write? So here, this one, you can write it as root 4, that means is equal to 2. Like this you can write. That means if you take it straight to this side, it will become root. So which number is there, that you need to write it here. So here again, this cube, if you take this one, you will get it as cube root of 8 is equal to 2. This one also, since 4 is there, you can write it as 4th root of 16 is equal to 2. What is the answer here? 2 is left out. And the next one, 5th root of 32 is equal to, what is the answer? 2. And the last one, 6th root of 64 is equal to 2. That means if you have any given in the form of the exponent, that we can write in the form of the roots. Like this you can write it. Why we written like this? Let us solve this one. I will prove one or two. You can do it the same way. Suppose if you want to, why we get square root of 4 is equal to 2? How we have written? If you want to prove, I will prove it this one. This one, you can write it as 4. You know that root, it will become 1 by 2. So here, what is there here? 2 is there. So we can write this one as 4th root of 1 by 2. Since here, 2 is there, we can write it as 1 by 2. We can write this 4 as 2 square. Can we write as 2 square? Right, because 2 into 2 is 4. You got it as 2 square whole power 1 by 2. Since we already stated a power m whole power n is nothing but a power m into n. So by that law of exponents, you can write this one as 2 power 2 into 1 by 2. So this 2 will get cancelled, you will get 2. Like that we need to solve. Just if you have given 2 square is equal to 4, if you take this square to this side, it will Just if you take 6 to this side, it will become 1 by 6, 5, 1 by 5, like that. Now, if you want to do this one, we can do it 5th root of 32. Again, 5th root of, by using the prime factorization, you know that 32 we can write it as 2 power 5. So here 2 power 5, whole power 5 is there, so you can write it as 1 by 5. You will get 2 power 5 into 1 by 5. This 5 will get cancelled, you will get the answer as 2. So, if you take any square to the right hand side, it will become true. By seeing all these examples, right, in the form of the variables. That means if you have given, if a power n is equal to b, how do you write this one in the form of the roots? Just if you take this power to this side, it will become root. We will write nth root of b is equal to a. Like this, we can write it. That means if you have given any equation in the form of a power n is equal to b, then we can write it as nth root of b is equal to a. So, this you can write in the reverse manner also. That means if nth root of b is equal to a, then we can write a power n is equal to b. You can write vice versa, any way. This is nothing but the class of exponents. And how do you convert if you have given power in the form of the square? Now, see the next concept, which is nothing but the surge. What are surges? Surges are nothing but when we can't simplify a number to remove the square roots or cube roots, that we call as a surge. Let us see, based on the few examples, what is meant by surge. When we cannot simplify the number to remove the square root, any root it may be, whether it or cube root or any root, then we call it as an surge. So, based on reading this statement, you cannot get a clarification. Just by taking few examples, definitely you will get a clarification about this search. What are search? When we can't simplify the number to remove the square root or cube root or anything, then we call it as a search. Consider example root 4. Here, can we remove the root here? Yes, we can remove it. Why? Because this one you can write it as 2 square. Right? Here, 2 square, I already told if nothing is there, means 2 is there, write it as 1 by 2. So, it is in the form of a power n, whole power n, we can write it as 2 power 2 into 1 by 2. This 2 will get cancelled, you will get 2. So, here, we have given 1 root value and we calculated so that we remove the square root. So, we can say that root 4 is not a surge. Because here we remove the square root, so we can say that root 4 is not a surge. Consider root 2. Can we remove the square root here? We cannot remove the square root. So we can say that root 2 is a surge. Because root 2, we know that root 2 is nothing but 1.414 and up to so on. But we cannot remove the square root. So we can say that root 2 is a surge. Similarly, root 3 is a surge and root 5 is also a surge. And if you consider root 16, it is not a surge because if you calculate here, you will get 4 square and this one you can write it as 1 by 2. You will get 4, 2 into 1 by 2. This one will get cancelled. You are removing the square root here. So, we can say that root 16 is not a surge. So, what is meant by surge? When we can't simplify the number to remove the square root or the cube root, that we call it as a surge. In the tomorrow session, we are going to discuss few problems regarding the third class of exponents.